inside Rogers Center in downtown Toronto. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Colorado Rockies and the Toronto Blue Jays. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. So almost ready to get underway. And our starting pitcher here today, Bowden Francis.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
So in now for Colorado, Charlie Blackmon. And he deals. And that's outside. And we are underway. Is fouled off. The pitch. Fouls it off, still 1-2. And there's a ball.
It's a good take.
That hit him. And the leadoff man is aboard to start the inning.
You know, Boog, there always seems to be that oh no moment for the pitcher when he's lost control of his pitch, and most of the time it's right when he lets it go. He knows that it's not headed where he intended it to go.
Ezekiel Tovar, the next to hit, takes ball one. Francis goes 6'5", 27 years old, and he was drafted in the 7th round. Back in 2017. Right through there for a strike.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
And a foul ball. A 1-2. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. Nobody out. Runner at first. Fouls that off to the left and will do it again. The 1-2. And another ball. Hit on the ground to the right side. And it goes just foul. Quick feed to second for one. On the ball, back. Two.
He's so good at coming across the bag and snagging it with the bare hand to throw. I like the flair that he brings day in and day out.
Ryan McMahon steps to the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Counts 1-0.
Two outs in the dirt, and now 2-0. Out towards right center field, Springer on the move, and that is that. So they go quietly there, and now the Blue Jays will get their initial shot. No score. And we're back. Today's starter for Colorado, Dakota Hudson.
He really relies on working down in the zone with that heavy sinker he's got. You know, it's not as popular to throw that pitch today as it used to be because, you know, guys are looking to hit balls down in the zone, get them up in the air. It's very important for him when facing same-side hitters to be able to get it in, especially early in the count. And to opposite guys, be able to throw it at that front hip and run it over the inside corner.
Bottom of the first. Now a chance for George Springer. That one misses in the dirt.
Starts him off with a breaking ball, which isn't surprising. They're trying to keep him off balance, but he's been known to connect on the breaking stuff, too.
Strike two.
Clearly, he was sitting on a fastball right there. Just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
He caught it behind his back, and that's a great play for the out. Let's take a look at the lineup for the Blue Jays. And, Chris, this group has been struggling to put up runs lately.
Well, they haven't been on base a ton, and even when they are, they haven't been hitting very well with runners on base. So they need a guy or two to really step up, have some quality at bats, hit according to the situation, and sort of break out of this. I think if they do, the rest of this lineup will follow.
Here's Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Next offering misses, ball two. And that clips the inside corner.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Swing and a high fly ball in the air left field. And it's off the top of the wall. Throws to second. Not in time. It's a double.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
Bo Bichette up to the dish. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Count 1-0.
Man at second. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Started to go after it. Now a look down to first. No swing. He held up. Patrick Johnson with the call there. At the belt and fires. Hammers that one deep left field and forget it. He'll circle the bases and they grab the lead. It's 2-0. That was blasted.
Absolutely. No doubt off the bat. Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
So one out, nobody on. Here's Daniel Vogel back. There's a strike. Pitch.
I got a ball, one strike.
Still only one out here in the inning. The other way, and now maybe extra bases. takes the turn. He's digging for second. They'll throw in. And he's out, trying for two.
Gotta love the hustle and the attitude there to try to stretch that single into a double, but unfortunately thrown out at second base. He was so close to being in scoring position.
Hard hit, left side. Tosses to first, and they get Biggio for the out. Third out, but two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Back after this on the show. All set for the start of the inning. Here's Chris Bryant now.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's got a leadoff double.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ballgame. But all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
And now it's Elias Diaz. That pitch gets the corner. It's 0-1. Man at second. That one missed. Gary Simmons has the plate duty in this one.
Well, with Simmons, it's not always your standard strike zone boog. It kind of gives a little extra in some parts of the zone and then can be tighter in others. But I think the important thing is he doesn't get labeled as inconsistent. So you got to stay ready up there.
Nope.
Next offering is downstairs. Yeah, one of those umpires, you just have to know what to expect, right?
Exactly.
Here comes a pitch. Lifted in the air, right center field. Guerrero sizes this one up. Brings it in. Runner tags at second. The relay throw. He makes it to third. Good base running to move up with only one out. Now here's Nolan Jones. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
Pitch misses there. Yeah, that's ball two.
If you're a guy that can only hit to one field, then you're really not going to be able to come through in clutch situations because pitchers are going to adjust. But because he's able to use the entire field, that's why he's so successful in these situations.
That one fouled off, 2-2. And the right-hander deals. Fights it off, you'll see another. Bichette. Slings to first, but they cut it to one as the run comes in.
The second base, Brendan.
Now it's Brendan Rodgers. And that one is in for a strike. Right side. Springer there makes the catch, and that'll do it. One run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on. Now to the bottom of the second. Blue Jays 2 and the Rockies 1. Back now in Toronto. And the batter now, number 36.
Snyder.
And a pitch. And downstairs. And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball two. And a pitch. And that is in for a strike. And it's 2-1.
Nasty 2-0 slider there for a strike. That tells you he's got a lot of confidence in that pitch.
Great on that fastball.
Well, don't expect too many more high fastballs. This is a good sinker ball pitcher, and sometimes they can make mistakes trying to pitch up in the zone. Look for him to stay down around the knees to be effective.
Kicks and fires. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk. And now it's Dalton Varsho. Pitch misses. 1-0.
Ball one, no strike.
Fought off foul.
Pretty good pitch to take a pass at in a 1-0 count. Just not able to square it up.
Kicks and deals. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss.
Well, the hitter shows the pitcher that he's willing to go after that pitch down in the zone. So perhaps he'll come back to it. Still trying to get that ground ball double play.
That misses the zone. Now 2-2. That one drilled him. And no chance for him to make the play. Let's just hope he's all right. The comebacker got him down low, and you can really see him favoring the leg. That's his plant leg, which might be a concern, Chris.
Yeah, you hope he's got some feeling in that leg so he can land on it, like you said. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay and try to continue, Boo.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. First pitch misses. This one in the air, center field. Doyle should have this one. Squeezes it. So up next, Ryan Servin looking for his first big league hit right here. And yeah, that's outside, and it's 1-0. The pitch. Offering popped in the air right field and puts the squeeze on that one. Two down.
The right fielder, number 4, Joel Springer.
And the batter is George Springer. Grounded out his first time up. just missed.
Count 1-0.
Next offering is in for a strike. First and second, two down. Bottom half of inning number two. So now 1-2.
1-2.
That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. One and two here. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Sizing this one up. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Blue Jays leave a pair. They lead it 2-1. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top half of the third inning. So in now for Colorado, Elauriz Montero. Francis back to work. And that's off the inside edge. And that is ball one. Big swing and a miss.
1-1.
And there's your strike.
A 1-2 count. All he's seen is fastballs. You've got to expect something off speed. Stay back.
That's the third. Connor Falefa gathers and throws to first. Leadoff hitter gone in the third. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Brenton Doyle. That clips a corner. One out, base is empty. Next pitch is outside. Swing and a pop up. Biggio moves towards it. He's got it. And there's two down.
The batter. The designated hitter.
Here's Charlie Blackman, hit by a pitch leading off the ball game. That misses, ball one. The Rockies trailing by a run. We're here in the top half of inning number three. That misses the zone, and it's 2-0. Should be extra bases around first, heading for two, and that's a double.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard, like you did right there.
So a man aboard, digging in, Ezekiel Tovar. He hit into a double play his first time up. Slapped the other way, foul. Man on second, two down.
Well.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Two outs. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Varsho makes the play, and it's out number three. So one left for Colorado. They're down 2-1. Bottom of the inning. And now the center fielder, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
The wind of the pitch. Breaking ball inside. Yeah, that's ball one. That's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
The wind of the pitch. Yeah, now two balls and a strike.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
And the righty deals. Right through there for a strike.
Just a really nice slider down and in there. He wants to get the hitter thinking fastball, speed him up, and just subtract some velocity and add a little movement.
And the pitch. And down on strikes. One away.
Well, I can't argue with that one, and clearly he was looking for something else. Anything but the breaking ball. It's a great pitch to hit right there if you're looking for it, and kind of a gift at a two-strike count. But sometimes you just get fooled, and you got to tip your cap.
Bichette batting for the second time, and that's strike one.
Dangerous spot for that slider right there. Didn't seem to quite finish out front and get that sharp break. I'll tell you what, he doesn't want to throw that pitch again.
No ball, two strikes.
And that one hit to first, and foul ball. Next offering is in the dirt. Bounce to the left side, and that's a fair ball.
Turned on it nicely. Definitely a little out in front of the pitch, but he didn't hook around it too much and was able to keep it fair down the line.
Runner on at first with one gone. Daniel Vogel back at the plate and immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. And takes low for ball one. Left-hand batter waits. And he grounds one back up the middle, and he can't come up with it. Beats the second out there. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. On to inning number four. Blue Jays 2 and the Rockies 1. As we go to the top of the fourth, stepping in, Ryan McMahon. When you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list. The right-hander back to work. And a foul ball.
This guy plays third base like he's a shortstop, and he welcomes the difficult play, can throw from so many different angles, and makes really tough plays.
Now this one is hammered way back there, on its way. And we are tied. That one felt good. Third home run of the season. It's 2-2. That one just sounded different.
And might have been the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I can feel that swing from the booth. With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, You'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient and waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. And now the right fielder, Chris Bryant, in for a strike, 0-1. So what are the skills you look for that make a really good defensive third baseman that elite?
Well, Boog, one of the things I think about immediately are just the feet. Does he have good feet? Is he able to quickly react? And when you have good feet, you've got soft hands. And soft hand defenders are able to make tough plays look easy.
The throw to first, Bryant out of the play.
Elias Diaz.
Next for Colorado, Elias Diaz, 0-1 with a fly out to center. Just missed. And that's outside, and the count is 2-0.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
Ball three.
Couldn't chase that time. Base is empty, one away. Top half of inning number four. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
That just came apart right there. Four-pitch walk, and the guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
Here's the left fielder, Nolan Jones. 0-1, he grounded out in his first at bat. Jones, 25 years old, and he was a second-round pick back in 2016. There's a strike.
1-1.
Diaz, the base runner at first with one out. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
One ball, two strikes.
A 1-2.
Ball two.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Two now. And misses inside. Man at first, one away. And there's a rocket into the outfield. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
He was all over that one. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
First and second, one out. Brendan Rodgers digs in now. Liner caught it second.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
So first and second with two outs. And now here is Elauris Montero. 0-1 so far. And it's through for a hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at third, so it'll be bases loaded and two gone.
Waste no time there. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Two outs. Base is full. Here's the center fielder, Renton Doyle. Out to short, Bichette. They get the force. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. But we're all tied up thanks to this solo homer. 2-2 game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back here at Rogers Center, John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Kevin Biggio. the pitch. And that's in for a strike.
Well, these Jays doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
And the slider just misses. Up the middle. Oh, look at the stop. Fires to first, and they get the out. Take another look at it, but this time with the numbers from StatCast.
Yeah, Boog, that's about as good as it gets. You'll see the hardest throwing infielders reach 90 plus on throws across the diamond, so he's pretty much right there with the best infield arms in the game. That was a rocket of a throw right there.
Number 36 in the box now. No balls and a strike. Gets down for a hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I could see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
And now here is Dalton Varsho. Next pitch is downstairs.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself in the scoring position.
All tied up. We're here at the bottom of the fourth. The 2-2 now. Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch on the outside corner.
Righty delivers. And ball four, two aboard.
Now batting, the third baseman, Isaiah.
And next for Toronto, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. He's 0-for-1.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Pitch misses there. 1-0.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
The 1-0. And that's outside.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
2-0. Sinker gets the bottom of the zone, and that's a strike. Runners at first and second with one gone. That one missing inside. Bryant serving on deck for the Blue Jays. And he walked him.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
One down. Brian Servant will hit next.
And there's one thing on his mind this at bat, getting that first hit at the big league level.
And fouled off. Comes the 0-1.
I got one ball, one strike.
And I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield. And another ball with a layoff that pitch down. Wouldn't chase that time. Greg, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
And a pitch.
Not sure exactly what he was thinking there. Good sinker ball pitcher goes with the fastball in a double play situation when he needs something on the ground.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. That one gets down for a hit. Runner from second crosses the plate for two now. Brian Servin with his first major league hit. And this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard and has to wait so long for this to happen. And when it does, it can kind of be overwhelming, dude. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you can take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you worked to get here.
Back to the top of the lineup. So up next for Toronto, George Springer. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two on, one out. That's off the mark. 2-0. The Rockies have some action in the pen. Cal Quantrill getting ready to come on for Bud Black. That's downstairs and outside. Righty to the plate. And there's the automatic.
Clearly taking all the way there in that 3-0 count. It was a cookie right down the middle.
Bounced up the middle. Dives, but it kicks off his glove to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe as a run scores. So first and second with one gone. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. now 1-2. That one finds the zone. And that is strike one. Missed. Servin at second. Springer over at first with one away. Two to third, McMahon. Off balance feed, there's one. And their second double play of the day will end the fourth. Three runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Blue Jays 5 and the Rockies 2. Now in Toronto, and here is Charlie Blackman. Francis back to work. Just off the outside edge. Ball one.
But all these Rockies doing a good job of putting the ball into play, and that makes things more challenging on the defensive side. They have yet to strike out, and they're averaging more than a hit per inning. That's a great recipe for success right there.
That one misses, and now 3-0. That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Man at first, Ezekiel Tovar getting ready to hit. That one's in there. That's strike one. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and he breaks his bat. Biggio makes the grab. And there's one down.
The first baseman, number 24, Ryan McMahon.
Ryan McMahon digging in for the Rockies. He's already homered here in this one. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-1. At the belt and fires. That pitch gets the inside corner, and it's nothing in two. And that's too high.
That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball. It's going to make that pitcher really have to respect this hitter, even though he's behind in the count.
The punch out there, that's the second out.
I mean, there aren't many curveballs in the sport today that break like that thing does. Huge movement. It's so difficult to get on the same plane and even think about squaring it up, let alone get a piece and hope he throws something else to keep the at-bat alive.
Chris Bryant gets a chance to hit here. That one off the mark, and it's 1-0. The Jays leading by three, and we're at the top of the fifth. He swings and fouls one off. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. A two-run homer, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 5-4.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
Elias Diaz now at the plate. This one lifted in the air, left field. Varsho brings it in for the third out. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's now a 5-4 ball game. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. And we're back, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now, Bo Bichette.
Not shortstop.
As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers. Swing and a line drive, base hit out into center field. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Recognized the break on that pitch early, and that allowed him to keep his front shoulder in. You know, it's easy to bail on those front door breaking balls, but a great job right there of letting it travel, then unloading a nice balanced swing.
Daniel Vogelback next up for the Blue Jays. That clips the corner.
Well, these Blue Jays showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. The numbers say their chase rate, or swings at pitches outside the zone, is under 25%, and I think it's a big reason why they're scoring runs.
Now a fly ball to right center. Bryant hauls it in, and there's one away.
By not chasing out of the zone, they're getting good pitches to hit. When you can do that, you have a much better chance to square up the baseball and do damage like they have so far.
Kevin Biggio up to the plate.
Hey,
line drive caught.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get some high fives. You know, when you make great contact, you feel like you've done everything right. But in this game of baseball, not everything is in your control.
Next is the designated hitter. Right down the chute, strike one. Two outs. Swing and a miss.
Well, there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Next offering way off the plate. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. In time, the 2-3 strikeout ends the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. We're through five. It's the Blue Jays 5 and the Rockies 4. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Trevor Richards.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Now the left fielder, Nolan Jones. He's a guy, Chris's highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms in the sport. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Yeah, the infielders and the catcher can never give up on a play, because if this guy thinks he has a chance, he's going to throw it from the warning track if he has to.
Right-hander kicks, deals. On the ground. And that chance handled in plenty of time to first. One up, one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Ball, that's outside.
Movement in the Blue Jays bullpen. Chad Green up and throwing. Pearson also throwing. Base is empty, one away, and we're the top half of the sixth. And now 2-1.
Good spot there, but didn't get the strike at the knees, and doesn't seem too convinced by the call out there on the mound as he tries to get a better sense of the umpire strike zone.
Popped up to the left into foul ground. Connor Falefa drifts towards it, calls it in, and there's two away.
That was a good hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop up and an easy out for the defense.
And there's a foul ball. And he deals. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2. Two outs, bases empty. Gets a piece and stays alive. Two down, nobody on. And that one is in the dirt. Now 1-2. Swing and a ground ball. Biggio fires over to first. It's a 1-2-3 inning for the Rockies. Nothing across here this half. 7-8-9 due up in the home half of the inning. It's the Blue Jays 5 and the Rockies 4. Back now for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Cal Quantrill.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Here's the left fielder, Dalton Varsho.
The left fielder, Dalton Varsho.
Why the kick, the pitch. That's in for a strike. Stirring in the Colorado bullpen, Jalen Beeks getting ready to come on for Bud Black. Oh, one down. That one fouled off. Right-handed reliever. That one ripped. That's down. One hops off the wall. And that's a leadoff double.
Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Now the third baseman, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. First pitch just misses.
Count 1-0.
There's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
The 1-1 is fouled off.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. Here comes a pitch. Swings and misses, struck him out.
That's a pretty nasty pitch right there. I'd call it a power curveball in the 80s. It's got so much spin on it, and you really don't have a lot of time to sit back and watch what it's going to do before you have to commit. It was a good one for the swing and strikeout.
Serve in the box again. Takes a strike.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
And it's second. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. Barshow over at second, one down.
One ball.
In the dirt, but kept close. Nice job behind the plate there. The pitch. Fouls it back with two strikes. Quantrill back to work. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two gone now. So back-to-back strikeouts now, and they still haven't managed to do anything with the leadoff double.
Yeah, Bogan, you just don't want to get careless here. You've done a really good job to get two outs after that leadoff double, as you mentioned, and just got to execute your pitches, and it's a non-issue.
So the batting order turns over. Here's George Springer, 1-for-3. And there's the strike. Runner at second, two down, here in the bottom of the sixth. Now
outside,
1-1. And the right-hander deals up the middle. And that one handled over to first. That takes care of Springer. That's the third out. So they work around the leadoff double. We're through six full. It's the Blue Jays 5 and the Rockies 4. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Chad Green.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
And a pitch. Doyle at the plate now, and that's inside. And now it's even up. Looking to get the tying run on base.
Ball
check two. Swing, no appeal.
We got two balls, one strike.
Now all leave it up. And down on strikes he goes. And one out now. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And a foul ball. Ripped towards third. Sends it to Vogel back. Two up, two down. So digging in, Ezekiel Tovar. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. And a strike. And you played behind guys, and they love having your speed out there defensively. One of the things that we talk about is how much pitchers enjoy having those elite defenders behind them. Next one off the plate inside, and the count is 1-1. Two outs. Swing and a foul straight back. And good work there as it gets a 1-2-3. Rockies are down quietly. They trail it 5-4. Bottom of the seventh. And now for the Jays, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Logan, the one thing about that is speed never goes in a slump, and defense shouldn't either. Hitting wise, you can struggle, you can lose your mechanics, but the thing that you can do consistently every single game is play great defense if you're talented in that way, and this is what this guy does.
The wind and the pitch, and that's outside, and that is ball one. And Chris, beyond the fact that he's so incredible defensively, he also can swing the stick. And there's a strike on the outside corner. And it's fouled away. A 1-2. And they'll do it again. Quantrill back to work.
Ball.
Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. And here comes. Stays alive. On the ground to short, Tovar. Whips it across, and Guerrero is set down.
The batter number 11, shortstop.
So up next, Bo Bichette. And it was a homer back in the first inning that got his day started at the plate.
Yeah, Boog, a two-run blast as fans were just still getting into their seats here at the ballpark. So if you showed up late to this one, you missed out on a big moment early on.
Hammers that one deep left field, and forget it. Another homer, his second home run of the game, and they add on. It's 6-4.
He just sparked this home crowd in a big way. What a swing.
Good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
And now the first baseman, Daniel Vogelback. And that one wrapped foul. Towards left center, on the move to the gap, and he makes the catch, and there's two down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Biggio in the box with two gone, and takes a look at a called strike. And now the count is even. Kicks and deals. Foul ball. Breaks his bat, pops it up. McMahon makes the grab, and that will end the inning. Bo Bichette goes yard for the Jays. It's a two-run lead now at 6-4. You're dialed into the show. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Tim Mazza.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Ryan McMahon digs in now. He's already homered in this game.
Ryan McMahon.
The pitch. And that's in for a strike.
Looks like he sacrificed a pitch right down the middle for tracking and timing. Some good hitters will do that.
Left-hand batter waits, and that one is lifted in the air. Drops in for a hit, couldn't run it down. Safe at second with a leadoff double.
Well, that's how you respond. Leadoff man comes up, gets into scoring position. Now, there are several ways that they can get this run across.
Chris Bryant digging in for the Rockies. First offering, and it just misses. Hard grounder into the outfield for a nine. They're waving McMahon home. He'll score, and they trail by one.
Picks himself up an RBI. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield, and Even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
Looks like we've got a substitution at first. On a pinch run, Michael Tolia. Here's the catcher, Elias Diaz. Corner infielders up on the grass expecting a bunt. Puts a bunt down. Vogelback goes to second for one. Throw to first, but he beat it.
That play won't be trending on social media later on, but it's still important to execute it to perfection. This game is a lot harder than it looks, partner.
Nolan Jones will hit next. Known for his late inning heroics. Territory for the catcher. Makes the grab. Two down.
Well, that's a frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter right there. I mean, that pitch was right down the middle. I think he got a little too excited, came out of his mechanics. Instead of driving that ball somewhere, he popped it up. Unfortunate for him.
Out in front and foul to the left side. With the go-ahead run at the plate, and we're in the top of the eighth. Lifted in the air, out to left. Makes the catch, inning over. But they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's tightened up a bit at 6-5 now. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Now into the game, Michael Tolia. He takes over and right. New pitcher in the game for the Rockies, Ryan Feltner.
Well, he's a big-time strikeout guy out there. This season, averaging more than one per inning.
Well, one-run game, and now to the plate. Here's the Toronto DH. The wind of the pitch. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Montero hauls it in for the out. And there's one away.
Really nice job to get your first out of the ballgame.
Now the left fielder, Dalton Varsho. Right side, hard hit. Montero takes it to the bag. And a couple of quick outs.
Now batting. The third baseman, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the third baseman, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. There's nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped, caught out in front, and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on.
Now, Ryan Servin. And that one fouled off. Kiner-Falefa leads off first with two down to the inning. Feltner picks over. Kiner-Falefa dives back in. And the 0-1.
Nope, at the ball. 1-1.
Runner on the go. Pitch outside. Throw is low, and he can pick it.
Really nice swing of second right there. He knew he had to get a really good jump on the pitcher, because that catcher can make up some time. Man, such a good catch and throw guy behind the dish. Nice job right there, but he just beat it.
Next offering way upstairs.
Love how this guy grinds out at bats. I mean, he's down there at the bottom of the lineup in the nine hole, but he's worked himself into a really good hitter's count trying to pick up a two-out RBI.
Man on second, two down. Ripped on a line to center. brings it in, and that will end the inning. Blue Jays held in check as it remains a 6-5 ball game. Now, and on the mound, the closer, Yimi Garcia. He comes in with a chance for his second save of the season. Well, one-run game, so in now for Colorado, Elauriz Montero. And the pitch. And a good eye there. And another ball. Good hitters count the 2-0. And fires in a fastball at 95. And a 2-1 on the way.
That's ball three.
Brenton Doyle up next for the Rockies. Ground ball right side. He handles it himself. Now one gone in the ninth.
That's why you hug the lines on the corners late in a ball game like this. Positioned perfectly.
Brenton Doyle digging in for the Rockies. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. First pitch doesn't find the zone. There's the strike. And now one and two.
Really going after him here. All fastballs to get ahead in the count.
Wouldn't chase that time. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Well, really nice job of finishing the hitter off right there. Outside command, fastball firm to the outside corner. Tell you what, very difficult to do anything with that pitch, even if you do swing.
Rockies down to their last out. Now it's Charlie Blackmon. First pitch, and he just misses. And the righty deals. Next pitch in for a strike, and a count 1-1. One-run game here at the top of the ninth. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there's just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
So digging in, Ezekiel Tovar. And that one fouled off.
Typically, the outfield defense will play a little bit deeper just to keep the ball in front, make sure that runner on first doesn't come all the way around to score and tie this ball game up.
Just missed. Next offering is in for a strike.
One down, two strikes.
One strike away. Got him, and that's the ball game.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
6-5 the final here today. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Fans are final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Blue Jays. Six runs on 12 hits. No errors. They left eight runners on base. For the Rockies, five runs on nine hits. No errors. They left six runners on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 33 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.